Welcome to tonight's Music on 4, where the Foo Fighters talk about their new album, Wasting Light, and play some tracks too. There's some strong language.
In a career spanning 16 years, the Foo Fighters have released 6 multi-platinum albums and won 6 Grammys. However, since their huge Wembley Stadium shows in 2008, it's been all quiet on the Foo's front. All that changed in early 2011 as the band returned to the UK to play a few intimate shows.
All my life I've been searching for something, something never comes. Least nothing, nothing satisfies. I'm getting close, closer to the prize at the end of the road. All night long I dream of the day when it comes around and it's taken away. Leaves me with the feeling, know the feel the most. Feel it come to life and oh yeah! Cold down, don't you reason? You're such a delicate wrist. And if I give it a twist, something to hold when I lose my grip. Will I find something in there to give me just what I need? Another reason to bleed. One by one hitting up my sleeve. One by one hitting up my sleeve.
Successful as the Foo Fighters, you can make an album anywhere and anyhow you please. Never ones to do things by the book, for their 7th studio album, Wasting Light, the band used Dave Grohl's garage.
It's nice to not do the same thing over and over and over again. Especially after 16 years, it's like every album's been a little different from the last, and some people love some of our records, some people don't like some of our records. And I'm glad, because that means that there's some diversity in there, you know?
This is the garage where we actually did most of the recording. When I first moved into this house, I used to do demos here with this super shitty drum set that in this room sounded like a fucking Led Zeppelin record. It sounded so good.
I think that Dave's always looking for ways to keep the process exciting for everybody, and probably for himself. It seemed like every time we do anything, there's sort of a overarching theme to it, you know? This time the theme was do it in the garage and do it on tape and kind of pull it back a little bit like that.
This time around, I thought, you know, I want people to hear what it's like when the Foo Fighters play in a garage.
I love this record. The last couple of records we've been working on this other dynamic mid-tempo songs, and I like the more straight ahead hooky heavy rock songs.
My numbers are printed.
Wasting Light is the first Foo Fighters studio album since 1997's The Colour and the Shape to feature former Nirvana and original Foo member Pat Smear, now officially back with the band full-time.
It's nice to have Pat to be objective, you know, like Chris and Nate and Taylor and I have been making Foo Fighters records for a long time, and before Pat came back to the band, he would always listen to them and be really honest about them. I love it. I think it's great. I think that's pretty cool. I don't think it's the best thing you've done, but I like it. You know, we always really paid attention to what he had to say because he knows what it's like to be in the band, you know?
I was in the studio every day. It's a small, very small room, the control room. There's not a lot of space to hang out, but Pat was there every day and just the most enthusiastic, just excited about everything, and you kind of need that.
The funny thing is, there's three guitar players in the band now, yet the drums are louder on this album than they've ever been on any album since I've been in the band. And it's because Dave kind of had this idea for this technique. If you listen to a song like Rosemary, everybody's kind of ping-ponging off each other and doing these single line things. And in actuality, it gave more space.
We all had like a specific kind of place in the song. I'm a rhythm guitarist. I play the guitar like it's a drum set. And Chris is a really rudimental, melodic guitar player. He could play just better than anybody else, basically. And Pat straps on a guitar and it becomes like a steamroller, you know? And all of those things together make for this one sound, and that's what we are.
Back to the roots flavour of the recording sessions was the band's choice of legendary Nirvana producer Butch Vig and the use of analogue tape to capture their raw energy.
I like the way we sound. I like it when I sing out of tune. I try really hard to make it sound good. That's as good as I can do. Our drummer is one of the best fucking drummers I've ever seen in my life. Why the fuck would I want to line him up like a Kraftwerk record?
This is where we did all the recording. The thing about using a tape machine is you can't manipulate the performance in a computer. If you have to edit anything, if you like the first half of this take, but you like the second half of this take, then you literally come out with the razor blade and do manual edits. Like this, see? This is probably one of Taylor's shitty drum fills that we didn't use for the record.
The first song we recorded, the tape started falling apart, started shedding. And everybody went into this panic. Oh, see, no, can't use tape. Tape doesn't work anymore. Can't, gotta use a computer. It's like, what the fuck? You know what we would have done 20 years ago if that happened? Get another fucking reel of tape and do it again. What's wrong with that? Oh, I'm sorry you have to play the song twice. You know what I mean? Like, it's not rocket science. So, it only made sense to do it that way.
Dave's like, if I see a fucking computer in the studio, besides your laptop, email, and friends, I'm gonna grab a baseball bat and I'm gonna smash it right in front of you. This is my house, and there's no fucking computers to record on. We're doing it on tape.
As long as I've been playing music, I've only made a few records, like whole albums. And they've all been to tape. I'm just used to the tape anyway, so that's all I know. So it was really comfortable for me.
On the way, Dave Grohl, the godlike genius and video director.
This is my method of directing.
That's right.
Minimalist. Cool. Let's do it one more time. Okay, the first time was better. Let's go.